Long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny, and now the time comes when we shall redeem our pledge. India will awake to life and freedom.
Hey guys, please do subscribe to Unacademy CA Aspire for more CA related content.
Hello viewers, welcome to Unacademy CA Aspire. On this Republic Day, we bring to you an all exclusive interview with All India Rank 1, Abhay Bajoria, CA Finals November 2019. Welcome, Abhay, and firstly, heartily congratulations from the whole of Unacademy team. Before we go ahead, let me introduce Abhay. Abhay is a Kolkata-born St. Xavier's graduate, a complete cricket maniac, and a big Virat Kohli fan. Abhay is also a movie buff and web series binge watcher. He completed his articleship in Kolkata on his journey towards securing All India Rank 1 in November 2019 CA Finals. So the first question, Abhay, how was your reaction when you saw the results and did the president call?
So I had actually taken a leave on the day of exams for my office, and I was just watching a web series, The Vampire Diaries, in fact, on that day, just to not think about the results. So yes, President Sir called me, ICA President Sir called me, and I asked him whether you're prank, whether it's a prank call or not. So I was absolutely shocked, and at the same time as I was overwhelmed, and it was just surreal for me at that point of time.
So when you achieve something this big, your parents would be really proud of you. So how was your family's reaction when they got to know about the results?
So as I said, President Sir called me. So I made sure that he talks with my mother, because she was sitting besides me only. So I made him talk with her, and she was crying. And when I saw those tears of joy on her face, that was the moment for me in my entire life. And I would say even my four and a half years of this journey was worth it because of that single moment. So it made me really, really proud that I can to see those tears of joy on my mother's face. That was something really, really special.
And who do you give credit to your success?
Well, there are lots of people for the reason behind my success. But obviously, the first and foremost are my parents, my mom, and my father. My father is no longer with us, but he was the one who used to teach me during my schooling years. So I do miss him a lot, obviously. And of course, my mom. She has sacrificed everything for me just to see me get everything. She has sacrificed a lot on a daily basis. So seeing her, I realized that this is the most selfless love any person can do to anyone. So yes, obviously, my parents are the biggest reason. And of course, my teachers, my mentors, my guides, my friends, all of them have played a very crucial role in my success.
So how was your preparations 3 months prior to the examinations?
So 3 months prior to my examinations, we get around about 5 months of study leave. So I got around about 5 months of study leave as well. So 3 months before the examination, my target was to make sure that at least I'm done with first revision of all the 8 subjects. So that was a pre-conscious decision on my part that I will be doing all the 8 subjects. Not like that I'm just focusing on group 1, because I've seen a lot of people categorizing all the 8 subjects into 2 groups, group 1 and group 2. So that was one thing which I had decided in the beginning, that if I'm going to give both the groups, then I will be focusing on all the subjects equally. So that was something which I did, was that I had completed all the 8 subjects at least once before my 3 months period had begun.
And did you prepare your own notes for audit and law subjects like that?
So law and audit were the 2 most difficult subjects for me. I knew that practical subjects, that is my strength. So law and audit are completely theoretical subjects, so it gets kind of difficult for you to memorize everything. So yes, I did make notes, small notes just used to write something in on the book itself instead of making a complete notes, because that is it involves a lot of time to make proper notes as well. So you have to manage the time as well, and you have to obviously make certain notes as well so that it is easier to revise before the 1.5 days that 1.5 days that you get before the exams. So yes, I did make certain notes, but not that much.
And the new costing syllabus, they say it's a bit tough. So how did you manage that?
Actually, on the contrary, I found it to be the most interesting subject of out of all the 8 papers. I remember telling one of my friends right before the exams, in fact, 3 and 3.5 months before my exams, that this is the subject after reading the ICI study material itself. I got a satisfaction after reading that book. Because it involves a lot of new techniques and new models and world-class techniques and different models are being discussed in that book. And it involves a lot of case scenarios and case studies, which I found it to be very interesting. So I told my friend that even if I'm failing the subject, it doesn't matter, because the kind of satisfaction you are getting after reading a particular subject, a particular topic, that means a lot. So that was very interesting for me. So I never found it to be that tough. Obviously, the new syllabus, the new costing book is a bit different from what it was. It was more practical oriented before. Now it is more case scenarios and analytical. I definitely like analysis, doing analysis. Mm-hmm. So case scenarios and case studies were something which made it to be very interesting. So I found it to be very interesting.
And Abhay, how many subjects did you study per day? Because there is this myth that, you know, all India rank holders, they study all 8 subjects in one day. So how many subjects did you study per day?
So actually it is a complete myth. You did not study 8 subjects in a day. In fact, it is a waste of time. You cannot study 8 subjects in a day, because you will not get any kind of rhythm or any kind of flow if you're studying 8 subjects in a day. That is not humanly possible, I believe. So what I made sure was that I made a combination of 2 subjects, not exactly 2 subjects a day. Even if I'm not doing 2 subjects a day, if I'm doing 1 subject a day, I made sure that if I'm doing a certain subject a day, I'm not going to repeat it the other day. So next day I used to make sure that I'm doing a different subject the next day. So what I did was that I made combinations of 2 subjects, and like a practical subject with a theoretical subject, something which is my strength along with something which I fear the most. So audit and law were 2 theoretical subjects. So I did it with SFM and FR, which were 2 practical subjects. So that is how I used to make combinations and do 2 subjects at a time.
And one day prior to the examinations, how was your preparation? Like, were you doing a lot of revision, or what was your strategy?
So one day before the examination, it is very, very crucial. All your 4.5 months or 5 months of study, which you have done during your study leave, depends upon that last 1.5 day. Because no matter how many times you have revised that subject, it's very important the day before the exam that you are seeing all the concepts. It's not possible that you are going through everything, but you have to see from the broad topics which you have done and the notes which you have made. So that is very important. That is where the notes come into play. So yeah, you have to make your notes and you have to just go through the important portions.
And in subjects like DT, do you prefer regular batch or do you prefer fast track batch mode of preparation?
I did a regular batch only from Vinod Gupta sir. So I don't find any difference that you have to do a regular batch or a fast track batch. It depends upon the time which you have. The articleship which you are doing, so how much time do you have and what is your position in with regards to the other subjects. So that is very important before deciding whether you want to take a regular batch or a fast track batch.
And did you take up any practice test series?
No, I didn't took any test series as such. Writing speed was never an issue with me, so I didn't feel the need to do a test series. Yes, but obviously I did complete all the MTPs and RTPs. I went through the questions orally.
And sometimes during your preparations, like, you know, myself, when I was doing my CA foundation, so you feel like, you know, you feel frustrated and you feel like, can I actually do this? Mm-hmm. So that hampers your confidence. So how did you overcome that?
So actually it happens with everyone. It happened with me as well. It is very much obvious and it is very much natural that since you are isolating yourself from everyone for 5 months, for 4.5 months, it's not easy. And CA being, it is a monotonous syllabus to a certain extent. Things can be repetitive at times. So especially in theoretical subjects, we have to memorize. So it is but natural that you will feel demotivated. At times you will feel like giving up. And it happened with me as well. I remember I called up my friend and I told her that yaar, nahi ho raha hai. It's not possible for me to continue with this course and I want to give up. But it's very important that you don't give up at that moment. Take a pause, take 15 minutes or take 2 hours off, do something which you like, which is your passion, and try to refocus again. Try to keep motivating yourself. So, and you can use different kind of techniques or methods. So one thing which I did was that I used to take a calendar with myself, and I used to put a tick mark or a cross mark on every day. I had set a target of 12-13 hours a day. So whenever at the end of the day, I thought that, yes, I have put in effective 12-13 hours. Mm-hmm. So I used to put a tick mark. Otherwise, I used to put a cross mark. So every week at the end of the week, I used to total it and see how many tick marks I have got and how many cross marks I have got. And trust me, I got more crosses than ticks. But yes, that kind of kept motivating me, that yes, I can do it. And I'm actually somewhere close to my target.
So during the examination, the starting 15 minutes, the time that you get to study the question paper, how did you manage that time? Is there any strategy that you thought about?
So yes, there's 15 minutes. Lot of people have called me up. They have texted me as well and say they one thing they ask is how do you manage those 3 hours of examination. So one thing I have always told them, it's not 3 hours, it's 3 hours 15 minutes, because those 15 minutes of reading time which you get is extremely, extremely crucial. So my strategy was that during the first 10 minutes of the reading time, what I used to do is that we have to attempt 5 questions out of the 6 questions which are there, out of which the first question is compulsory question which we cannot skip. So the first 10 minutes was devoted in finding out which question is the one question which I'm not going to attend and which I'm least comfortable with. So I used to skip that question. So I used to put a cross on that question which I'm not going to attempt. And the rest 5 minutes were, the last 2-3 minutes of my 15 minutes were devoted towards that first question which I'm going to attempt first. Because you have to make the first question really great, because that is the first question which the examiner is going to see. So that puts a whole impression on his mind. So it's very important that you're writing your first answer very properly. You should be attempting that question first, which you are most comfortable with, and where you can impress the examiner. So yes, if you are devoting the last 2-3 minutes thinking about what kind of answer, how you will start that answer, so it helps when you are actually writing the exam, when you are writing that answer.
And during the preparation time, how many family functions and get-togethers did you have to sacrifice?
Okay, but so I didn't attend any family function, any get-together. Sorry, family, sorry, relatives. I heard a lot and I had to hear a lot from my relatives. But my mom made sure that I'm not going to attend any function or any get-together. I told my mom at the beginning itself that please don't force me to go anywhere. So, I didn't attend any family function or get-together.
And one thing that you want to tell to the repeaters, what would that be?
Don't lose confidence. This is a course which obviously tests you a lot. This is a challenge. And obviously, it is tough. And if it is not tough, then it is not worth it. So to repeaters, it's like that. Everyone has got their own timeline. So it's not necessary that you have to clear it on the first attempt as well only. I've seen lots of people in real life example who have not managed to clear it on the first go, but yet they have managed to make it big, really big in life. So it's not necessary that you are doing it on the first attempt only. So everyone has got their own timeline and it happens for the best. So whatever is happening is for the best. So what you have to do is to keep believing in yourself, your methods and preparations, your strategies. Do self-introspection, obviously, where you are lacking. But yes, don't lose your hope and don't lose self-confidence. So that is very important.
So now that you've got All India Rank 1, so what do you want to do in life right now?
Right now, I would like to enter a job, do a job, preferably in investment banking or management consultancy. Those are the two areas where I'm looking forward to join. I'm doing my CFA as well. My level 3 is due this June. So I would like to complete that. Mm-hmm. And obviously I would like to do executive MBA. So that is on my wish list. So, but that will be happening after 4-5 years. So let's see. Yeah.
So while doing your articleship, mm-hmm. So how did you manage work with studies?
So obviously it was very difficult. I won't say it was very easy. What I made sure was that I decided that I will be completing all my tuitions before my study leave begins. Mm-hmm. As I had told earlier, we get around about 4 to 5 months of study leave. Mm-hmm. So before my study life began, what I thought was that at least let's get completed with all my tuitions and all the videos which I have to watch. So that during those 4-5 months which I'm going to get, I'm only devoting all my time towards self-study, because it's very important that you are doing self-study regardless of the tuitions and coaching which you are taking. It's very important that you are doing self-study. So what I used to do during my articleship was that in the morning I used to attend one tuition and after that go to office. And during my first year of articleship, I was also doing my graduation from St. Xavier's College. So we have compulsory attendance over there. So obviously I had to go to college as well and then to office. So during first year of my articleship, I had not started any of my tuitions. After that, once my college got over, so I devoted that morning time towards my tuitions.
And social media is a huge distraction these days. So how did you manage to get off social media, and how did you manage your time during the examinations?
So I was like completely into social media almost 24/7. I was a 24/7 guy type. Every time you will find me with my phone only and on any kind of social media platform. So it was a conscious decision on my part that before 1.5 years of my before my examinations, I thought that let's get isolated from the social media. So overnight I cannot think that I will leave everything. So what I decided was that I will first leave Facebook, then WhatsApp, and then like that. So yes, but I was active on Instagram 15-20 minutes a day. Okay. Every day, even during my examinations.
Thank you so much for your time, Abhay. You've been a huge inspiration for all the youngsters out there, and I hope lot more people follow in the same footsteps. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sudarshan, and thank you Unacademy for having me over here, and thanks a lot.
दिखा कुछ क्योंकि तेरे हाथ में करने का अभी मौका तेरे पास में है. करते जा, लड़ते जा, हिम्मत नहीं हार, सबको करके दिखा. क्या तेरा भाई तेरा दोस्त तुझसे बोल रहा, कर दिखा, लड़के दिखा.